I'm Carrie Gracie. My guest today is a diplomat, Shaozu Kang, Chinese ambassador to the United Nations.
Talking about Taiwan, it's a fact that Taiwan is a part and parcel of China. It has always been part of China. Taiwan is the most important issue. That is to say, this issue on which we don't have any room for compromise.
But why don't you just shrug and let the Taiwanese do their own thing?
Well, I think for any sovereign country in the world today, you know, no country will tolerate, you know, the division of the country forever. History, you know, we are product of history, product of the civilization. That's the way we look at it. And according to United Nations Charter, you know, the sovereignty, territorial integrity is the most sacred thing. It should be protected. We treat the territorial integrity more important than our lives. Life. It's very pragmatical approach. No force on the world can shake Chinese nation's determination to achieve the unification of my great motherland. Let me say, the moment it declares independence by Taiwan, supported by whoever, China will have no choice. We'll do the business through whatever means available to my government. Nobody should have illusion on that.
This obsession about Taiwan, it constrains your foreign policy. It forces you into a straitjacket of talking about certain kinds of reactions which would inevitably profoundly damage the economic development that's been so central to the Chinese project for the past 30 years.
Economic development, we want it. Because without economic development, you cannot do anything else. It's very, very important. You know, China is a developing country. You know, to improve the standard of living of our people is the priority job of my government.
And yet, and if you go to war over Taiwan,
if
then
we
you're...
go to war, but if we have to choose between sovereignty, territorial integrity, and economic development, we will choose the maintenance of state sovereignty and territorial integrity. This is the other core interest. But once we have achieved, you know, this integrity, we still have time to build our economy. But if China is forced to choose, you know, I told you, we'll choose the territorial integrity.
Well, it's a high
before.
Price. To, it's a high price to pay after for a few square kilometers.
Yes,
you know, miles
you are right. You are right. You know, I said at any cost. It's not a matter of how big Taiwan is, you know, how useful it is, but for China, 1 inch of the territory is more valuable than the life of our people. We are never concede on that.
About military might. China's leaders talk about peaceful development. Why then is China building up its military forces so assertively?
China's military power or build up military power is very much exaggerated. You know, China is a huge country which, like any sovereign country, is entitled to national defense. And our military budget is very moderate, you know, particularly in terms of per capita income, it's very, very low in the world.
And yet, the American Defense Secretary, Donald Rumsfeld, says that China is spending more than the government acknowledges, that it's expanding its missile capabilities, developing advanced military technology. And he says, why? Why pour all this money into the military at a time when China needs as much as it can for its economic development, at the same time as China faces no threat from any other country? That's
we
the American
don't
position.
Need we don't need anyone to preach and teach us, and no one in the world is qualified to teach and preach China. And the United States, as far as the military business is concerned, US is the least qualified guy to preach and teach China, because it has the biggest military arsenal in the world. It's the most advanced technology and science technology for their military build-up. It has the biggest, well, the biggest military budget, yet this guy is telling us, China, you should stop. It's not in your interest. Okay, it's better for US to shut up. Keep quiet. It's much, much better. China, the military build-up is not threatening anyone. It's for legitimate defense. If you don't have any ambitions, you should not be afraid of. You know, you read our history. China have not sent any. So we are not fighting anywhere. We are not killing the innocent people anywhere in the world today. But look what they are doing today. So, and we have to be careful to make sure no one in the world can harm China. We are determined to defend our country. With little bit military increase, they are trying to make a huge story about it. I want to tell U.S. that, are you the number one? Is it true that you have almost 50% of the world military budget? And why do we have that? And China's population is 6 times or 5 times that of the United States. China's territory is as big as the United States. Why blame China? No, forget it. It's high time to shut up. Don't preach and teach China. You know, I'm sorry, because I'm being not diplomatic in using my language.
Well, it's quite interesting, isn't it?
But I feel very strong about it.
Yes, and it clearly makes you angry.
You know, we don't have any soldier abroad. We are not killing anyone. Look what the way they are doing in the world today, right? So China is threatening. China's new build-up is not in China's interest. Who knows China better? China itself knows it better. China is not a member of any military alliance. Look, being a superpower, it is building up all kinds of alliances in the world today for the defense of the territory of the United States. Right. Don't tell us anyway. It's U.S. sovereign right to do whatever they deem good for them. But don't tell us what is good for China. Thank you very much. Our military capability is exclusively for the self-defense, to make sure to deter those who dare to harm China.